A London tribe is disappearing. Men who worked on the Thames when the docks were the beating heart of the capital. For them, it was more than just a job.
You couldn't wait to get to work. There was a great atmosphere on the river.
One of the most exciting, interesting jobs you could have.
You never earned a lot of money, but you just had a right laugh, and you were never skint and you were never hungry. I miss it really badly still today. I actually dream about docking barges in Surrey docks.
Everyone was working and it was just a lovely environment, and it was a way of life. It wasn't just going to work, it was the whole way of life. Everyone knew each other who worked on the river, and it was just lovely.
My family have been working on the Thames for over 400 years, and I've been recording the memories of these men before it's too late.
Everyone had money in their pocket, there was plenty of work, you know, and at the east end of London were the best tippers for cabs. And also they were mostly short ops, because kids would go from one sort of pub to another, you know, what were busy pubs in those days.
How can I explain it? I never ever had a Monday morning feeling. I went to work, never ever blew out. If I'd like a drink, I'd sit in the chair all night rather than be late the next morning. It was a wonderful place to work.
These lightermen, as they're called, are still up for new challenges.
Hello, Alan. How are you, mate? Bobby Clements. Listen, Al, do you want to tie a barge down with me? When was the last time you brought one down from Brentford, Al? This will be your last chance. You want to do it or not?
People don't realise how dangerous the Thames is,
George, do
they?
They're
not taught about it.
Mark Twain said, the Missouri is a river, the Mississippi is mere mud, but the Thames is liquid history.
Very well put, Thomas.
Thank you very much,
very
George.
Very profound statement.
Have you told them about where we nearly got killed in Poplar Dock, George?
No, I will tell you that.
There are still many stories to be told of their lives then and their lives now.
One night I did go where gowns were cut low, and there I saw a woman tattooed from head to toe. Her shoulder blades were Japanese, and on her back was tattooed Greece. Her hips were Siam, her legs Vietnam, her thighs were like the Isle of Skye. But when I looked for Hong Kong, her old man came along. So I let the rest of the world go.